Gosh, they worked awful darn hard, and I'd like to take a minute to thank a couple of the people who helped this show that are not in the program. Helping with our makeup is social studies teacher, Mrs. Sandra Schwerer. Just helping with backstage and anything we need help with is Mr. Reed Francis. And Mr. Lemuel McCann. It's a nice one, folks. I'll do this all night. And last but not least, running our light board tonight is Miss Amy Rodriguez. Something else, though, and that is that, well, some of the music in this show, it's rather modern. It's rock and roll, they call it, and it's a little too loud for my taste, and I'm sure some of you might feel the same way, but hey, it's what these young people like, and as I say, you gotta go with the times, don't you? I mean, after all, here we are, more than halfway through the century, 1953. My God, remember when that seemed like such a far-off date? Anyway, I don't have to tell you about the subject of our story. You've all heard about Conrad and Bertie, the small-town boy who took American music by storm. You've read in the papers about how he's been drafted in the army. He's going to go across the seas and fight the beast of communism. And you've read about all the uproar that's been greeting this announcement by our young teenagers. But it did occur to me that as famous as Mr. Bertie is, we do have some more mature members of the audience that perhaps have never been to a Conrad Bertie concert and don't know how to act. And later in the show, you're actually going to be in the audience when Mr. Conrad Bertie goes on television. That's right, folks, on the Ed Sullivan Show. And so I thought we'd go over a few of the signals. You know, some of them are familiar, like you might know this one here.
Thank you. suggest that the boy does not want to go into the army. It's just that... No, no. That's not it. But sir, you misunderstand. It's... 2 weeks from today. At the induction center. He'll be there. Rose! Thank God you've come! It's the end of Al Mae Lu Music Corporation.
I'm afraid the secretary's requesting me with a resignation.
Mom?
I just wanted to say goodbye, Alvin, darling. Lots of love.
Rose, you can't. Not today of all days. My pills. Where are my pills? The little white ones I take when I'm overwrought.
Here.
Not so much. Will you break it in half?
You're 33 years old, Albert. You can take a whole aspirin.
33? I am not 33. I am a long way from 33. I won't be 33 till tomorrow. Why?
Albert's no use. I've been with Al Mae Lu 8 years now. People know I've been a lot more than just a secretary to you.
Rose! Those are moments of madness.
Well, between the moments of madness in the office, I put a good 90 hour a week. And for what? A $5 raise in 1954 and a bottle of Arpège last Christmas?
Promise her anything. But give her Arpège, Rosie.
Oh yeah, and not a 16th of an ounce.
Thank you.
get the money to pay Conrad's guarantee? And when I'm out of the red, I'll dissolve our window and go back to the academic.
How are you on?
Of course, it may take a while, but I'm sure that by 1973 or 19... What's that?
Something that's going to push that date up for a few years. Pick a name.
Pick a name? What are you talking about?
Oh, boy, I'll do it for you. Kim McAfee, age 15, present recording secretary, Conrad Brady Fan Club, number 2748, Speedup, Ohio. Mary, would you give me Speedup, Ohio? The number's capital 7820. Call me right back.
Wait a minute. What's going on here? Who's Kim, whatever the heck her name is?
Kim McAfee, Albert. Is this going to send you back to college with the biggest song this business has ever seen? It's called One Last Kiss.
I've never heard of it.
You haven't written it yet. But when you do, when that one last kiss to Conrad Brady on his way into the big cold army for 2 long years, when he gives that one last kiss to one of his fans towards that random, will make Mr. Brady the hottest Anderson's Joan of Arc.
Rose, I'm beginning to see it. We cut the record here in New York.
Take that greasy bone in your feet to Sweet Apple.
Let him kiss that kid.
And release the record. Albert, you'll make enough money to stay in college for the rest of your life.
Rosie, it'll be perfect. Just the two of us. The perfect bliss. I'll get a job teaching English and... Hey, bliss. Kiss that rhymes. I wonder if anybody's using it. Oh, what the difference does it make? It'll be great for the song.
One last kiss. What is your
I'm sorry.
Sorry I'm late. Now let's go over that pretty song one more time for me. Hey, you know you're not supposed to smoke. Drop that. I mean it. I'm serious. This is Albert J. Peterson.
So?
You won't be able to stay with your team wife if you don't do that.
So funny.
Remember, the condo is pretty creepy here. No smoking until you're 14.
Life depends. Volunteered, I heard he was drafted for the appeal. Oh,
that I present to you this solid 14-karat gold key to our city, so generously donated by the men at the Sweet Apple Brass Works, to you, Conrad Birdie. Excuse me. All I said was Conrad Birdie. Now, if you girls don't stop that, I'll never finish my speech.
Thank you.
She really admires him, and she loves him a lot.
They're going to cut in on Sweet Apple at 8:05 tomorrow.
And for that reason, I beg you to put aside your petty differences, since you're all going to be on. To that audience out there, that great audience, you're an American dream come true, to be on the Ed Sullivan Show. And for the free world's sake, Mr. McAfee, don't destroy that dream. I'm going to be on television with Ed Sullivan. Ed Sullivan! Me, Harry McAfee, appearing with Ed Sullivan! Ed Sullivan! Ed Sullivan!
Albert, Albert Wu is dissolved? Dissolve me? Who am I now? getting a limousine to take me to the final resting place. I'll walk.
Sing, everybody.
We love you.
was Ursula.
Yes, let's give her a hand.
She will now demonstrate the Conrad Birdie scream. When you hear his name, you're supposed to scream at the top of your lungs. However, we need some help with that. And for that, we welcome the Sweet Apple Teens!
You're not alone, Albert. You're on television.
You've had a severe shock.
The best thing for us to do is to go to bed. There she is. The traitor stabbed me in the heart when my back was turned.
Get out of my way, Albert.
Be careful, Sunny. She may be armed.
I can handle her, Mama. You go upstairs with Conrad and see that he gets to bed.
Wait for me, Conrad.
That one last kiss will take place after all. It'll take place at the train station tomorrow morning before Conrad leaves. So, Miss Alvarez, it looks like your nefarious little plan has failed after all, as anyone must fail who tries to buck Al Peterson. A titan, a giant. I'm King Kong of the music industry. No one can beat me. Rosie, I mean you!
Sunny boy, whoever you call me!
right now.
Oh, Sunny Boy, you're right. I'll help you find her.
Only maybe I better give you the message from Conrad first.
What message?
Oh, nothing important, dear. He just said he's going out tonight. He doesn't think he'll be back on time. So skip tomorrow. That's all.
Mom, why didn't you tell me this before? What is the matter with him? Doesn't he realize how much this means to me? Conrad! Conrad!
Take it easy, I'm coming. Before you start hollering, Albert, I just want you to know I've made up my mind. I'm tired of getting up at 9 every morning, having people watch me when I eat, and letting kids poke me in the eye. I want to go out, meet a couple of young chicks, have some fun. Don't you understand, Albert? I am content.
Mama, do something!
Conrad! Did you ever think he'd put himself in work? Oh, a horror woman!
I'm not going to get that chance.
Yes.
talking about?
They're out together, having moonlight swims, and motorboat races, and loop the loop! I'm gonna do the only sensible thing. Drink myself to death.
Moonlight swims? Motorboat races? Loop the loop!
Doris, get my gun.
Mr. McAfee, you wouldn't happen to have seen Conrad, would you?
No, but I attend that zine very shortly, Mr. Peterson. So, if you have any message whatsoever, I'd be more than happy to deliver it to him right after I shoot him.
Shoot him? It's better than my Rosie!
What are you talking about, dear? You guys don't have a gun.
There's a Daisy air rifle in the garage.
That's my box!
Shut up!
Anything! That bow and arrow I bought you last Christmas with the suction tips! Don't just stand there! My daughter has run off to loop the loop the fiend! Get me a water gun! Shooter?
A pace shooter? What? Give it to me!
Yeah. Conrad and Jim.
They put off together.
And if we don't find them soon, Mr. Pearson, I intend on calling the FBI.
Who's that been out here? Is it Peter Lawson yet?
No.
I'm sure everything will be okay. I mean, Conrad's pretty responsible.
No, it's Terry. Have you seen Ursula?
Ursula?
Is she missing too? Since they're popping up everywhere.
Mr. Pearson!
Have you seen my Barbie? Or Roger? Or Phyllis?
Maybe there's... I'm sure they're somewhere safe. I mean, maybe they're down at the drugstore. The drugstore. Having one of those gang wars?
Gang wars!
What a score!
I'd forgotten that.
Really?